So if we go to the app IA Writer, open that up. If you've watched the video on this app that I've previously made, it's basically just a simple text editing tool. So it's pared back, there's no unnecessary information there. The formatting you need for TagPad, you have a heading first of all for each section. So let's put a heading of iPad. Straight under the heading, you have your first question. So is the iPad easy to use? Okay, and once you've got your heading, you can have free writing responses, so you can just leave them to write their own text as they do their survey, or you can set it up so there is predetermined choices. To do predetermined choices, what you need to do, you start with a vertical line and then you put your individual choices separated by further vertical lines. So let's put yes, let's put no, let's put sometimes as our three choices. Between questions within the same section, just leave one line space. And this one we won't put in any choices. If we want to do a new section, leave two lines for a new section. So I've left two lines now. We'll give it a new heading. We'll give it the heading apps. First question, what is your favorite app? The IA Writer app has a number of different storage locations for your document. So if you click on the file, it can store it on the iPad, in the iCloud, or in your Dropbox account. So at the moment, the survey that I've just made is actually stored in the iPad location. I need to move it to the Dropbox location. So the way you do that, if you go into, as I just did then, into the iPad section, click on the Edit tab. If I actually click on the blue arrow, it'll take me into that file name and give me some details on the file. If I click Move, I can then choose a different location for that file. So I want to move it to my Dropbox. Click Move, and that's now moved across to my Dropbox storage location. So if I go back, look at my Dropbox, we should be able to see the document is now there. And there it is, that document's now in my Dropbox, so I can import it into TagPad quite easily. And if we want to import a file, click on Import. I need to set up my Dropbox account. I'm going to open that up. Just need to put in my details. So I've put in my Dropbox account details. I've linked that up. You can see my survey text is there. If I tap on that, it will import it as my new survey. And here we go. You can see that I've got my questions. Is the TagPad easy to use? And I've got my click options. So that's pretty good. Do use the iPad a lot, and I've also got my sections, iPad and apps. So, fantastic. And now I can simply conduct my study, record my responses, I can add new subjects, I can edit the name of subjects, so you can do a whole range of different things. And I can go back to my studies, and when I have more than one study, you can just scroll along and see all of your different studies, open them up, edit them, re-upload them to Dropbox, etc. So I've gone and entered some information, two subjects for my study of the survey. Is the iPad easy to use? You can see the text has been entered in. I've also recorded some audio to go along with those two subjects. So there's Nathan and John. What we can now do, if we go back to my studies. So the final question is, how do we get the data from that survey off? Well, we click on upload. It processes the audio, it uploads all the data, the answers to Dropbox. If we go and have a look at our Dropbox app, that'll just update. And there we go, we've got all answers and all tags. So if we look at all answers, it lists all the subjects within that study and it lists all their answers on the questions. But that's probably not super useful. The better way to do it, it does involve working through a couple of other apps, but the better way is if you go to an app like Goodreader that will allow you to open up into other apps, and we really want to get this information into Numbers, the Excel equivalent for the iPad. So if we go to Goodreader, open up your linked Dropbox folder. If you then find that document, all answers, all tags, if you download those two items, wherever they might go, now we have those files in Goodreader. And by the way, if you're not familiar with Goodreader, go and have a look at the couple of videos I've made on that as well. It's a fantastic app that everybody should be using. If we click on Manage Files tab, oops, missed it, Manage Files, click on All Answers, then we get a range of options come up. Click on Open In, and let's choose Numbers. We can actually get all of those results imported into the Numbers spreadsheet, like an Excel spreadsheet. So if we open up that spreadsheet, there we go. We've got all our participants and all of the data. So we can add information as we like and rearrange it. So it's a fantastic way to use many of the features of the iPad to create, conduct, and then analyze simple surveys and interviews.